What up, broskies? Thanks for tuning back into the channel. I know it's been a while, but I do have a few surprises for you coming on. I did go to the Grange. I got to test out the truck and turned out pretty good. Even though I didn't make it the first time, the second time I actually made it and I got to slide the entire day. It was so reliable. I got to drift the entire day. The only thing that I had issues with was just the right pinion. I overheated the power steering fluid, but I'm gonna go from power steering fluid to Dextron 3 ATF fluid. Turns out you could actually switch them and it won't cause any harm. And right now it's currently, I believe, 11 p.m. and I just took off the spindles on both sides. Oh yeah, let me give you this little sneak peek. Oh, damn, is that coilovers? Yep, they are. But yeah, I have the spindles off. And the reason I have the spindles off, I'm gonna take them to Top Flight Fabrication right now. And he's actually gonna shorten where the outer tie rod goes about an inch. So that should give me a little bit more of steering angle, but it's gonna be mint. So let me go ahead and start putting these in the car and let's head that way.
Sitting throwing rocks across the pavement, hoping it will cave and swallow me whole. Wondering why my mind keeps on spinning. This isn't how living to me was told. Why am I like this? Something's always amiss. Can't put my finger on it, but it's there.
Everything you touch has a big eye.
Everything I touch.
Yeah.
So we got a man who said, fuck Jordan followers. Fuck him and his followers.
Stupid ass. Alright guys, so we just left Tommy's shop and we're about to start heading home. I'm pretty excited to put them on, see how much angle we got, but I am gonna have to replace the ball joints before track day while he was welding. I noticed they were really, really sloppy because as soon as he tried to stand up the spindle before even welding, it just, yep. So yeah, let's get home. All right guys, so we're back at home. There's a truck. So I did end up swapping out back to the original suspension that I had, which are 92 Chevy S10 shocks, which are from AC Delco. It's just spring assisted. You still gotta use your torsion bars, but yeah, that's gonna stay on there. The only reason I had the
SAE coilovers is I just wanted to really see how it would look like. They're not officially on. I still have to wait for them to create the mounts and upper and lower control arms, which they are in powder coating right now. But let's install the spindle. Alright, so one thing I do have to do before installing the spindle is I gotta cut this off so it can clear. Sending rocks across the pavement, hoping they will cave and swallow me whole. Wonder why my mind keeps on spinning. This is how living to me was so. Why am I like this? Something's always amiss. Can't put my finger on it, but it's there. Wait for it to subside, but my mind won't apply. Waiting for the clear. Is it bad sometimes? I like it when I lose control. There's something in it that's so beautiful. Alright guys, sorry about not recording everything else. My battery ended up dying. I ended up recharging my battery, but it's good to go now. All I gotta do left is just torque down the wheels. But check this out. Truck's back on floor. Let me get inside and I'm gonna show you guys the angle. It's like, holy shit. Alright. Put the steering on. There we go. Alright. So I'm gonna show you guys that angle, right? Watch. Alright, so that's straight, right? Watch this. Boom. You can almost see the inside of the wheel. I gained a lot of angle. All it was is just 1 inch. That's all we took off the spindle. 1 inch. Let me go ahead and turn this car off, or the truck. Take the steering wheel off. Ooh, pretty. So yeah, truck is done. Angle mod is done. And then I didn't lift it up, but what I did was instead of inserting the shock from underneath, I put it on top of the control arm. So it actually stiffened up with the spring that the AC Delco one has. But besides that, I mean, I'm not going to be slamming the floor when I hit the track now. All I got to do left is just wait for SAE to get the upper control arms. Head over there, leave the truck. They're going to install the upper control arms. And after that, they're also going to design the top mount. So that's pretty fun. Besides that, we're good to go. I hope you guys enjoyed this. And like, comment, subscribe, and you guys are going to see a lot more drift content coming. Peace, y'all.